you also did a lot of productions for Tha Realest, right?
Oh yeah, for sure.
After Tupac passed away and Snoop Dogg left Death Row, do you think that Tha Realest was the replacement of Tupac and Top Dogg was the replacement of Snoop Dogg?
Sure. Sure to me. Didn't have an appreciation and a respect for the uniqueness of the artist he had. He just thought it's rap or it's something, anything similar could replace it. Because it wasn't just Tha Realest when he brought Tha Realest in, but he brought another guy in called Top Dogg for Snoop. When Snoop left, he tried to sign a guy and called him Top Dogg. That's supposed to be in the replacement for Snoop Dogg. So he didn't, and neither one of them did the world embrace. Neither one of them took him nowhere near the original artist he had there. People wasn't interested. They didn't buy it.
Yeah.
So to me, he just didn't respect the uniqueness. He felt like he could just get another slim guy, name his name similar, and repeat the success again. And that shows that he just didn't know exactly what he had. Mm-hmm. Or he didn't respect what he had. He thought he could just throw somebody else in there and keep the thing going.
Was it not weird for you to work with Tha Realest after Tupac passed away? Because a lot of people say that Tha Realest is a Tupac lookalike.
That was my original feeling. Now, here's how this happened. Suge went to jail. Nobody's getting money but Snoop and maybe a couple of top artists. Everybody else is looking for their checks. I'm one of the ones. Makaveli is out selling, and I'm not getting paid for it. And we're all scraping just to live.
Mm-hmm.
Our per diem, where we were getting a month, which wasn't but $1,500 a month, Tyrone and I, that's all we were making. And we weren't getting that anymore. So Suge got a hold of me. I forgot through who. I think it was through Reggie Wright. And he said, I got some work for you. I got a guy I want you to put some songs on. And then his name wasn't Tha Realest. His name was Dominican.
Mm-hmm.
And so I said, a guy named Dominican, I want you to meet him up at Echo Studio. And, you know, I'll let you make a little money. There was no money being made. So when I meet this guy, I actually meet him down the street for the first time from Can-Am. And when I saw him and I saw some of his tats, I said, them exact same tats that Pac got. I'm looking at him like, this guy got Tupac's tattoos, kind of like, man. And then when I heard him, do something, I was like, this is a... Now, of course, my allegiance to Pac, I didn't want to originally work with him, you know, but it was the only money for me to make. And I remember specifically Snoop showing up at the studio later that day in his entourage. And I walked up to Snoop. He took a couple of pictures with me. And then I walked up and I told him, I said, man, Snoop, I ain't trying to, you know, like replace Pac or nothing like that. I said, this is the only money. And Snoop told me, man, if that's the only money that clown is, you talking about Suge, that's the only money that clown letting you make, man. Make your money, man. I ain't trying, you know. Now, I remember everybody who walked in there that day that were from the Death Row family, I remember explaining to them why I was doing what I was doing. And nobody thought checking about it. Nobody, like, man, that's cold. That's, you know, but I remember one of the outlaws saying, but who want to sound like somebody else?
Yeah.
You know, but it didn't come down on me, though. They didn't look at me like, you know, like I did anything wrong. I told them, it's the only money this guy letting me make since he went to jail. They don't give me my money. They said, man, make your money. I remember specifically Snoop was very supportive. He was like, man, if that's the only money that clown let you make, man, make your money. You know, but the problem I had with Tha Realest is when Tha Realest met me in my glove compartment, in my trunk and in my glove compartment, I had some of the original writings of Pac, stuff that had never came out. And what I didn't realize the value of what I was carrying until after he passed. One day I was going through my tablets And see, there would be tablets around the studio just for people, like, if they got an idea, they could write. Just so happened, I don't know, ironically, me and Pac were using the same tablets. I was writing songs, and he was writing songs. I was writing R&B, and he was writing raps. And then he would draw, doodle. He would doodle around and draw little things and stuff. And one day I'm sitting up, and I'm looking at some of the pages in my tablets, and they all Tupac writings. So the realist asked me, could he have them? He wanted to rap them. I said, no. So he even offered me money for the tablets. I was like, no, man, I ain't gonna let you rap his stuff.
Wow, that's pretty.
So I gave the tablets to Edie.
Wow.
You know, now I could have probably published them and made some money, but I feel like this guy helped my career. He helped my life. I'm not gonna sell his stuff. I asked Edie to give them to Athene.
Wow, man.
I'm hoping some of those tablets are in this place that you said. This Tupac thing you said, it's to the 22nd, that the Grammy thing, what you talking about?
Mm-hmm, yeah.
Yeah, I'm hoping some of those tablets are there, because there were songs that weren't finished. There were some songs that you're probably familiar with, but some that he was just writing things to, and like I said, little drawings and doodling. I thought all that was valuable, you know, show you what was on his mind at that time or whatever.